Okay, now in this section, we'll see the command line of the routers. If you remember, in the previous section, we have seen how to connect a router. So I'm using a router here, and we are connected to the router via console, and this is what you will see in a hyperterminal window. In that window, you can see the complete command line of the router when we are connecting. Okay, so let's start with the modes. So all the commands of the router are divided into different levels or hierarchical structure, we can say. And these different levels, we call them as modes. Now we have some user mode, typically very basic commands works. If you want to get into some advanced command, we need to get into the next mode. And if you want to make any changes, we have to go to the next mode. We call it as global configuration mode. If you want to do any changes on the interface, we go to the interface mode. Anything you want to change relating to routing, we go to the router mode. Anything you want to change on the line or to change the password, we go to the line mode. So we've got a different modes, we can say. So we'll be getting into more in detail on these modes one by one. So let's try to see what is exactly mode. So first mode, we'll start up with, we'll try to understand something called setup mode. So the first mode, whenever you power on the router, probably most of the time when you power on the router for the first time, you will see something called setup mode. Now how it looks, whatever the command line you see here, you observe here, now we call this as a setup mode. Now what exactly it is saying is, you get into this setup mode if your NVRAM is blank. NVRAM is blank. Now NVRAM, when it will be blank? If you remember, whenever the router boots, first it is going to load the IOS from the flash into the RAM, right? It's going to load your operating system, and after that it is going to load the configurations from your NVRAM. So which means whatever the changes you did before you power off your router. So right now this NVRAM, there is no configurations in this. If there is no configurations, which means there is nothing configured or nothing saved, then you will see this setup mode. So if your NVRAM is blank, and your NVRAM will be blank, either you are going for a new router which doesn't have any configurations, or maybe I'm using an old router which is in my storeroom. Probably I'm going to erase the startup configurations, or I'm going to erase, there's a command code to erase everything, and I want to use this router in my production network. And before I use that particular router in my production network, I'm going to erase everything in that. So whatever the reason, if your NVRAM is blank, you will see this setup mode, and it looks like this. It is going to ask you that there is no configurations present on the router. Would you like to do any initial configurations? Now what to do here? So we just need to skip the setup mode by simply giving the no command. So if I say yes, what happens? It will ask you many things, and it will ask you a lot of things to configure. So we can also do the configurations later on by going individually. So whenever you see the setup mode, you just need to skip the setup mode by giving a no command. That's it. Okay, just give no and skip the setup mode by giving a no command. If you want to check what happens if you say yes, you can probably try it out. Okay, so setup mode you will see very less, because if your NVRAM is blank, then only you will see the setup mode. If your NVRAM is loaded with some configurations, in those kind of scenarios, you will not see the setup mode. Okay, so right now, whenever you see the setup mode, simply skip the setup mode with a no command. Now the next mode, what you'll see, okay, once you skip the setup mode, you will see the message called press return to get started. It means that the router has finished the booting process. Now you are ready to, you see the command line and press enter keyboard to see the command line. So the next mode you'll see, we call it as a user mode. Now in case of user mode, what you will do? So in the user mode, you can do only some of the basic monitoring commands. And how you can identify the user mode? You will see something called greater than symbol. When you see the greater than symbol, you have to understand that you are in the user mode. That's what you can see here. This is a greater than symbol, which means I'm inside the user mode. Now in this mode, we can only do basic monitoring commands, like I can verify what is inside my flash. Now flash is having some IOS here, and the size of the IOS image and the total size of the flash, how much it is available and how much it is used. And even I can use some basic command like show version, and in the show version it will show you some information about the same information what we have seen, like what is the bootstrap program and what is the iOS version we are using here, and this is your bootstrap version, and what's the platform I'm using here, and then what is the image file from where it has been loaded. It's loaded from the flash. It will show you what is your main memory capacity, and then finally it will show you how many interfaces you have on the router, and what is the NVRAM capacity and what is the flash capacity. And one more information like configuration register file, we'll see this when we get into the password reverting concepts. Okay, in that case we generally change this register file. We'll see that more in detail in the password reverting. So apart from that, we can use some basic show commands like show IP interface brief. There is a command called show IP interface brief, and in this it is going to show you how many interfaces we have and what is the IP addresses configured on that interface, and then what is the status of that particular interface, whether it is up, whether it is down, these kind of things. So more on these commands we'll see when we start doing some more and more configurations, but I just suggest you to go through with these commands basic, just to type and just to get used to the command line of the Cisco routers. And apart from that, we can also use some of the basic commands like ping. I can use some ping command. Anyway, ping will not work here because we did not do any kind of configurations. Okay, and also there is a command called traceroute, something like this, 21.1.1.1. Traceroute also will not work here because we didn't configure any IP addressing on the routers. Once we do that, then probably we can also verify ping and trace commands on this particular mode. But apart from that, we can also use show version, just now discussed. So mostly this user mode will allow you to access only basic show commands, not all the show commands. In the user mode, we can only use some basic show commands and just a basic ping, basic trace, not more than that. If you want to do complete monitoring, or if you want to use all the show commands, in that case, from the user mode, we need to go to the next mode called privilege mode. And for that, there is a command called enable. So if you want to do complete monitoring or complete show commands, if you want to use, we need to give a command called enable. And once I give enable command, it will take you to the next mode called privilege mode. And it looks like this. You will see some hash to identify. And in this mode, we can use all the show commands. All the show commands works. And also we can use some copy commands to save your configurations. And also we can use erase commands. And also we can use ping, trace, whatever we have used in the previous modes. Okay. So let's try to verify some of the commands here with some command line. Let me go to the command line of the router, and what's the command we can use? Enable. So once I give enable, you can see the mode changes. Now the mode changes to a different mode, and we call this mode as privilege mode. Now here all the show commands works, like I can use show running config command to see the configurations in my RAM. You can see show running config. Right now we don't have much information about this because we didn't discuss much more on this. So whenever you see more, which means there is a more output to display, you can either press enter to see the next line, or you can use spacebar to see the page by page. Right now we didn't do anything on the IP addressing, we didn't do anything here, so just a command. And there's one more command we can use, show startup config, startup-config. And right now it says the startup configurations is not present because right now, if you remember, your NVRAM is blank. So startup configurations is the other name for your NVRAM. Right now it is blank. So whenever it is blank, you will see this message. Anyway, because we did not save any configurations till now, but once we do some changes, once we save the configs, probably we can verify this. And apart from that, we can use many show commands. We'll get into more and more show commands once we start getting into more and more topics. Okay, so some of the things we can do. But now the good thing about the Cisco iOS, let me just give some idea on the good thing about the Cisco iOS is it will allow you to use question marks wherever you want. That is what we call as iOS help. Let's say you want to see, you don't remember the command, and you just remember ST and that question mark. So when you say question mark, it is going to show you what are the commands whichever starts with ST. And if you say start, and there's a good thing about the Cisco IOS, even you can use S question mark, it will show you the command starts with S. And SH question mark, there's only one command starts with SH, that is show. Okay, so we can always use question marks to find the possible show commands after this, or possible anywhere, not only show commands, anywhere. So we can use spacebar to see the next page. Okay, we'll see more and more show commands as we go ahead. And even you can use normal question mark to see what are the possible options here. Now we call this as iOS help. Now apart from that, you can also use tab button. Another good thing about the Cisco iOS is you can use question marks, you can use tab button to auto complete the command. So auto complete means, let's take an example, I want to type show, and if you want to auto complete the command more similar to your Linux or Unix operating systems, if you use question mark here, you can see there is no other command starts with SH. So to auto complete, I can press tab button. When I press tab button, it will auto complete in the next line. And then if I say show run and tab, when I press tab button, it will auto complete the command, because if you just come back, if you say show run, there is no other command starts with run after that. So there's only one command. So the device will automatically understands that you are supposed to type the run and it will auto complete it. But when I say show R question mark, it will not, I think it's taking here anyway. And if I say show start tab, it will not take start, because the reason is with STA, there are two more commands starts with. Now the device will not be able to decide which command you're talking about. So that's the reason we need to add one more keyword called star and tab button. Why? Because there's no other command starts with show star. It's only one command called startup config. Okay, so that's a good thing about the Cisco iOS. And most of the time when I do the configurations, I use tab button to auto complete the commands. Okay, so I don't prefer to type the complete command. I always prefer to auto complete by using tab buttons. And apart from that, the third good thing about the Cisco iOS is we can also use some shortcuts. Like, let's take an example. You want to type show, you don't need to type complete show, or you don't need to type the complete tab. We can just type sh run. So run stands for running config, and sh stands for show command, because there is no other command starts with sh. So the router will automatically understands that you want to type show command. And then when you say star and then press enter, it will understand that you want to type question mark, just a startup config. And you can also always use up arrow key to go back to the previous commands, and the down arrow key to go to the next commands. So whenever you want to repeat any command, you can always use up arrow keys to go to the previous commands. So these are the two basic modes, we can say. The first mode is your user mode. Typically this is the first mode which you'll see. And in this mode, we can only do some of the basic commands, basic show commands. Not all the show commands will work. Now if you try these commands back in this mode, it will not work. Let's try some of the show commands on my previous mode. If you want to go back to the previous mode, we can always use exit command. And if I give show running config, you can see it's not taking tab. Even if I use question mark, it's saying unrecognized command, because this command is not supported on the first mode, that is the user mode. So if you want to use this command, we can use enable. Now the running config will work. Even show startup config also will work in this mode. Okay, so you must get into this mode. This is my privilege mode, where you can use all the show commands, and also we can use some ping command, trace commands, copy erase commands. Copy erase commands we'll see more when we do some changes, because when we do some changes, we'll definitely like to save the configurations. In those kind of scenarios, we'll use copy. And at the end of the basic commands class, I'm going to show you these two commands also. Okay, so but the thing is, you cannot make any changes in these modes. So if you want to make any changes, we need to go to the next mode. We call it as global configuration mode. So more on this global configuration mode, we'll see in our next video.